Alright, so the discussion is about men, men paying for all of the bills. And Freeman, what did you say?
Men paying for all the bills. Yes, if we are married, we definitely gonna pay for all the bills.
We? You speaking French?
Okay, not we. Yes, the men, I think that we should pay for all the bills and stuff like that. And, you know, that should be at least remotely enough. If we go to maybe out of town or something like that, go on a trip or anything like that, you know what your man's bills are. You know what salary he's on, stuff like that. You should be able to appreciate it because he's doing everything he's supposed
to.
So
you think that if you go on a trip, the woman's supposed to pay for everything on the trip?
I wouldn't say her pay for everything on else on the trip, but at the same time, the man is going to do what he can to pay for some of the stuff on top of everything else that he is paying for. Say what?
Is he taking her on the trip or is she taking him on the trip?
Well, if you're married, I definitely think that there would be a, you know, cool 50-50.
Sometimes you might want to come to your
husband. Yes, shut up,
Jazz.
We can't hear you.
But at the same time.
Or he might want to just surprise you and take you on a trip.
But yeah, exactly. But that means he should be able to save up little by little until up to that point. You don't know what kind of finances that he has.
How is he going to save up if he's paying all the bills in the house? What is she doing with her money?
Shit, he can have $50 per paycheck just laying around and stuff just to put it on the side. And then next thing you know, you might have a little road trip, a little cruise or something together. You might have another ring coming up. Never know that.
So what should the woman be doing with her money since she ain't paying the bill?
The woman's going to do whatever she wants to do with her money.
Oh, so you don't care what the woman does with her money?
I never said I didn't care with it, but I hope she would be responsible enough. I'm not a married man whatsoever. Like, absolutely. I'm not a married man whatsoever. I actually don't even plan to get married. But at the same time, I do see both sides.
What do you think, Alicia?
Mm. She, oh, you choked up now, huh? Oh, you choked up now, huh?
First of all, you cannot wait until you get married to establish that, right? I'm not about seeing it before we get there. That's how I am. I
you dirty. Question is, what is the time frame that you should get married?
I don't believe there should be a time frame on marriage. I feel like that's a sham. If you have a time frame on I used to have a time frame on my whole life about what I want to do in my whole life, but obviously that plan does not work out. Mm-hmm. The plan does not work out how you want it to do when you have a time frame. Things get messed up. You know what I'm saying? So I gave that all up because honestly, I mean, I was supposed to have two kids right now and all that, but time frame.
I know, right? What y'all waiting on, though?
Anyway.
Uncle Mike in the building.
So I guess what you're about to ask is, how long before you actually have that wedding day should you guys have started living together?
Yeah.
I mean, it really just depends on
it's not really a time frame. You cannot plan anything else.
I also think, too, that once you've been in something and you see that that's not going where you want it to go, and you put a lot of time into it, and you do it a second time, you kind of change everything that you do. So, I don't know. But I have to do it for some period of time before we even get engaged. It's just me. You know what I'm saying? But as far as paying the bills and whatnot, though, I've always done it by who makes what. So they can be fair. You know what I'm saying?
That's fine, but if a man is paying all the bills and stuff like that, and y'all know what's out, you got into the relationship on what salary he is on and stuff like that. What has he been doing for you?
Unless you know
what he makes. You have an idea what he makes and stuff like that. Yeah, salary does also change.
It can go up, it can go down. You can lose your 5. You can lose.
Oh, what? 2.5%? 5%?
You can lose everything.
Exactly.
You can lose everything. You can be the head of household and lose everything.
Okay, so how many girls that you know, if somebody lose everything, you ain't married, nothing like that. Oh, they just find a side dude. And they just find somebody.
I don't know.
How many girls y'all know like that?
I don't know. My best friend was my cousin, and he was in a coma.
Okay.
He lost everything, his whole financial everything.
Okay.
And she's still with him to this day. Okay. And she never cheated on him or nothing. Women don't always go out for the next dude.
Women don't.
We really love you. We're not looking for nobody else. We're going to love you broke, crippled, whatever. We're going to love you.
Okay, but that's... Y'all are one in a million.
And they're not even married.
That's not one in a million. Oh, it's definitely one in a million.
Because
there's not a lot of women like that out there. Like,
it also depends on how some women are women.
Freeman said...
Oh, definitely. Definitely.
The question is, should men...
Men too.
...take care of all of the finances inside of the household?
I mean, $2.20, no. It's down in the middle. It's cost 3 cents no more. the average person renting mortgage is at 50% of what they make. The average person in America. So how can you expect somebody to pay over 75% of what they make just to pay bills? So you got one person paying almost 100% of what they make just to pay bills, and the other person sitting back collecting 100%.
Well, see, at that point, you have to even it out. So I'll give you like this. Larry pays the rent. So I'll pay the smaller bills. And then when we go out, I may pay for dates and stuff like that. Because this is no longer him trying to get me. We're in a relationship for real, for real. So if he's gonna use almost all his money to pay the bills, then I do everything else. I mean, simple as that. There's nothing else he has to spend his money on besides the bills. So it doesn't matter if it takes up all of his money. So I got the rest of it.
That's what I'm saying though. But the way women go, it's like a team at that point, the way it was worded before
so you trust that I worded it wrong? No, I didn't word it wrong.
Because honestly,
maybe it's something who's
that?
She answered the problem.
Steve, what's happening, bro? But anyway, like,
I got cameras.
Wait, what are your video at? But anyways,
all I said was because the discussion has been coming up all week. I've talked to a couple people all week, and there's people say that men should pay all the bills in the household, a woman has no say about what goes on in the household.
No, absolutely not. Absolutely not.
You must show whole crew.
Okay.
But see, the thing about it is,
like that discussion we had at Evan's house, when Keith said that women shouldn't have a say so because the man pays all the bills in the household. You can't tell me I can't have no say so.
But see, you also gotta realize he's a Muslim. So Muslim men and other cultural men, they think a certain way. They feel as though a woman does not have a voice. A woman is nothing but your property. But in a partnership and stuff like that, we're both equal.
It doesn't
matter if I make more than you. It doesn't matter if you make more than me. I'm still going to be submissive to my man.
Right.
At the end of the day.
As long as your man is a man that you can be submissive to.
As long as he's an alpha male, yes. I'm going to submit to him every
time. Like men wants to have a joint account now. So both of our checks are going to our joint account. So at this point, it really doesn't matter who makes what, because all of the money every 2 weeks goes into the same freaking account.
And that's what most married people do.
Both to the same account. Granted, we have separate accounts, but our separate accounts is for his extra duty and my extra duty. Whatever we do extra duty at, that's going to your separate account. But your actual paycheck is going into this major account so we can pay the bills. So it's not like, oh yeah, Wesley's paying all these bills or I'm paying all these. No, the joint account is so all the pays can come out. That doesn't mean...
Y'all looking at your income as a whole.
Yeah. But my cousin was trying to say that, oh, because you guys split the bills 50-50, then he not a man, and you run the house, buy, all this bull crap. And I'm just
you gotta realize, like, he's a Muslim. Like, Muslim men think so much different than regular people. Like, other cultures, they think different. They don't believe in 50-50.
That's crazy. Like,
they believe in 80-20.
I grew up in a West Indian household. Mm-hmm. All my family's from the Caribbean. Okay? The way they see it is, it didn't matter that my dad paid every bill in the house. His only function was to go to work, pay every bill in the house, but my mother still ran the household because they don't believe in doing any household things in the West. They believe they go to work, you pay the bills, they pay the bills. My mom do everything. She decorates, she finds a place to stay, she cook all the food and she cleans it. So you can't sit up here and tell somebody that runs the house, physically run the house, that they can't have no say so in the house because they pay the bills. That don't make sense.
That's how it's supposed to go anyway, because that's how older relationships are. Right. That's how we were raised, that you know the man pays the bills and stuff like that. Like, when I was with my kids, I was with him for 13 years. And he didn't want me to work at all. He and Katie probably didn't want me to work at all. He didn't want me to do nothing but take care of them and go to sleep. That's it.
Yep.
He paid for everything. I've never paid for my own car.
Yep. And that, that's what,
that's how my grandma, lived too. Mm-hmm. Like my grandmother, she was able to build companies.
Yep. And that's, I mean, and now I think it is a little harder, obviously, the income does not match up to the cost of living.
And not only that, these men nowadays are racist.
There's true.
Yeah, most of these men nowadays, they're living off their women. Mm-hmm. It's a lot of them. They living off their woman.
The women.
Yes.
They want to be so independent. Sometimes they oversell the independence. So a man be like, well, you got it. And they just keep on going to the left and to the right.
See, I struggle with that. Like,
Me too.
I have been told that I am too independent to the point where it's actually intimidating. Which, I think it's because of the way my mom raised me. It's like, you don't really, as long as you can do it yourself,
you don't need a man.
Like, I mean,
that's how we were raised. And like, if the man doesn't do it, we'll do it ourselves.
That's for the longest time in my head, for the most time, I had the mentality I don't need a man. I may want a man, but I don't need a man. So obviously that has shifted, but for a long
but
time,
no, it's still, that has, like, it still should be like that, though. Like, you shouldn't need nobody else.
I think the problem
you should all you should want
the problem you don't is that need. Balance. The balance between the want and the need is hard to find that balance.
Five.
And I don't know everybody's situation, but if you look at my situation, single mom, that really reinforced that I don't need to. That reinforced that, because I've seen her do it without one, grandma did it without one for years on end. So you can't tell me nothing.
For the long time, granted, I didn't broadcast. Oh yeah, I don't need a man for nothing. I didn't broadcast it, but you can tell with like how I act and how I talk and how I treat men. Like, I mean, no, I'm at one particular time I was no nonsense habit. So if you did something stupid, blah.
Oh yeah, you.
So no, you're
around that time. I'm still like that. Like if you show me a vibe or something that I don't like or aura that I don't know.
Mm-hmm. Like for a long time.
I still do. My patience. Because when you know, when you're old enough and you know what you want and stuff like that, you don't settle for less. You know how you should be treated and stuff like that every time. You know how you doing.
So this is Jerrica. We work together. Well, not no more. She upstairs. She a detective.
Ooh. Detective stage.
You gonna take shots like that?
No, sister. She a detective. But yeah, so I mean, obviously I had to get out of that because like, you do that for so long, you run away people, and I'm like, I mean, the white dog, bring out the white dog,
not the black one. Bring out the brown.
Like, I had to obviously learn how to bring that down from a 20 to a 5, because a 20 to a 5, if you run away good people acting like that. Smart. And he was like, I mean, if it was going on the date, then yeah, that's fine. I'll open the door, but not, I'm not doing that every time. I'm not getting out the car saying, wait, babe, let me open your door, because that's just doing too much. He said that, he said you're compensating for something. And I'm just like, yo, that's crazy.
Now let me ask you something. Does he come from a two-parent household?
Yeah, his parents are married. But honestly, out of nine of my coworkers, he's the only one that does not open the door. For him and Bautista are only two that said no, that's doing too much. My sergeant said he still does it for his wife, but he said it's hard because he has the children now and, you know, getting all the children, all that little crap. But everyone else is saying, yeah, they still do it. But Marks and Bautista are like, no, that is just too much. So I guess the question is, not even just with the door, is chivalry dead? Do y'all think it's dead?
For some people,
I think it all depends on how you were raised. Like people who were raised with grandparents and mother and father household, where their father still gave their mother flowers, still surprised them with nice things and stuff like that. It's not dead to those people who were raised like that. But the people who were raised like, okay, well, I already got you, I don't have to do all that.
I don't know. I feel like I started off not caring about that, and then later on, I did care. But it goes back to what we were talking about earlier. I didn't care about that, so because I didn't care, the person didn't care either. Once I started changing my mind, I care now. So I move quickly, I move fast. I want to get in the door, I want to get out the door. I ain't got time to wait on you to open the door. That's how I was. So I opened my own door and I walked through it. And then about 2-3 years into it, I was like, let me just start slowing down. I get to a door now, y'all, before he does, and I don't wait at the door. And he knows that means to open the door.
That's true.
But it wasn't until I started demanding it that I started getting it. It don't mean it's dead. It's really about what you accept, what you ask for.
Because some women don't care.
Right. Some women don't care.
Because I know that when I was with my ex, I was younger than him. So he actually, like, told me, like, how a woman's supposed to be treated. Like, I used to move fast, too. Mm-hmm. I used to hurry up and get out the car and stuff like that. He like,
I also feel like, too, nowadays, a lot of women aren't really in that feminine mindset either.
That's what I said.
Because I feel like, we're too independent. We're focused on what we want. Like you said, you want to get in the door, you want to move fast, and you're not really stopping and saying, okay, well, let me let my man be a man. Let him open that door.
That's the one right there.
I mean,
that's
honestly,
for real, they don't.
I agree. With my last relationship, I feel like I had to learn that because I was taking the masculine role and I was doing for him. I was buying him things. When yet I wasn't getting those same things in return because he had taken a feminine role and he just took a back seat. Like, well,
and
she's going to do
it
all for me.
I was just saying this because you can. I said, most men don't want to be the man no more because
that is true.
They're living off their woman.
That is true.
And then roles come in first.
It has. I was buying him things. I was doing for him. Anything he wanted, I needed, but at the same time, I wasn't getting anything, so literally, I took a masculine role in it.
But you could be independent still, and there still be chivalry from the man, though, like,
you know what, but you have to think about the man and his mindset. If he's tried to be chivalrous, and you shot it down, you still get the hell out the car when you want to, you still open the door, you still move quicker than he does, after a while of doing that, they're gonna start to be like, you know what, she got it, I keep trying, and she keeps... Yeah. So let me just back up.
Because there is a thing of being too independent. And that scares men off. That scares some men off.
Yeah.
I think that's probably like why I'm still single. Because like I'm real independent now. Like now that I left my ex, like, I'm very, very independent. Like, and some guys get intimidated by that because like I don't. I'm not a part of your type. Like all I do is work and not be with my kids. So like that's pretty much it. Like I'll go out every now and then, but for the most part, I just work. Go like. I guess I'm not the type that most guys.
Right.
They want like the partier, the wild ones, the ones that need them. But you do have guys like that too. That they want
well,
to be
guys,
needed.
Guys, all men want to feel needed though. Because that's,
yeah,
that's,
but it's
because they're the provider, so they want to feel needed. If they don't feel needed, then technically you're taking away their masculinity and their manhood and all this other bullcrap that they're supposed to have.
But still, even though I'm independent, I still know how to be submissive to my man.
Right.
I still let my man always be a man. I never emasculate him ever. Like any guy that I've ever talked to, I never emasculate. I definitely don't argue with him around anyway. I hate when couples do that. argue with people around. No.
Yeah, I think if you have it depends on the issue. I think if you have an issue, you wait until you're by yourself and discuss it.
I'm a strong believer
in I don't think that people should know what's going on in your household.
Yep.
So I mean, that's just me. I don't know. Everybody's
different. Even if I don't like it, I'm gonna give you that app, and that means we're gonna talk to you.
Right, he already knows, right.
Yeah, you in trouble, bro. But
yeah, cool. Everyone is different, but
now there are times where like I want to real, depending on who I'm with. Like if me and Larry with y'all, I'm gonna turn around and be like, hey, he tripping around you. You know what I'm saying? Because sometimes I be wanting to know. Maybe I'm tripping. Maybe we need an extra hand to help us out.
Because sometimes us as women, we do be too much.
Right.
I be having to ask my best friend, right? Best friend. I tell you the situation. I'm like, okay, now was I wrong or was he wrong? Mm-hmm. Because sometimes we do be wrong, or sometimes we be right and we be like, okay, I know I was right. But let me just get a second opinion.
And sometimes you need the male opinion. I have no brothers. My mom's a single mom. So I have to turn to my guy friends or my friends.
So if I have a problem with something, I'll call the ex. Yeah. He's married now. So I'll call the ex.
A lot of times, my friend's husband, boyfriend will be like, let me tell you something. You're not wrong, but you got to know how he's thinking about it on his level. We take things more serious than that. So where I feel like it might be a lot of disrespect, Larry might be thinking about it on the more simplest level in the world, and he didn't mean anything by what he did or said. I'm thinking about it over here, and so he don't understand why my reaction is the way it is. I don't understand why he's so nonchalant about it.
So, see, I've got told that I'm nonchalant about things. I got told that I kind of act like a male when it comes to, like, emotional things and stuff like that. Like, I don't dwell on stuff. I don't hold grudges. Like,
see, and some men probably don't know how to handle that. They're like, why is she not upset?
Yeah. like even my coworker, like, he just be like, we can get into it. And it's just like, so I'm done talking about the
whole. Oh, you over it.
Yeah. Well, that's like the and they're not used to that. They're not used to women just like that. Mm-hmm. And like, I'm like, I don't know if it's because I'm new to down here. And I'm like, because I'm a city girl. And like, I guess they think like.
Like a city girl, not like the city girl.
Well, the culture is very different. My mother's from the Midwest, from Chicago. The culture is so.
Yes, the guys down here are so different.
So different.
So
I'm on a bad one.
Because they say like the South is where like all the country guys are with the have like chivalry, mm-hmm. and they're so sweet and stuff like that. But to me, like, they kind of a little soft.
Ooh, not the S word.
my coworker got mad at me because I called him soft. Because I'm just like, because like when we argue about something at work, like he getting his feelings about it. I'm over it right then and there. You know what I'm saying? And that's what I'm used to. Like I don't dwell on stuff. Because when you hold grudges and when you let stuff hang over your head, it kind of take away from you. And it take away from your peace and stuff like that.
I mean, I would say the guys here are nicer.
I don't know. So, I mean, I was with them when I was 13, so I can't really speak too much on the guys and the difference. But my mother from Chicago, and then when she was a teenager, she was raised in South Florida. I've gone back to South Florida. I visit friends my age. And when they talk about their men, I be like, that's not any man in North Carolina. They're not doing that. You know what I'm saying? So it's got to be different. Because multiple people from other places are all saying what you're saying. It's got to be different in some way. The chivalry thing, what throws me off with that was I was always taught that countrymen are very chivalrous. Mm-hmm. And I'm from the South, but it's not Southern, so there's a big difference between the two.
Yeah, and people don't understand it.
That's not the same thing at all.
Because I say guys from Alabama, mm-hmm. and Tennessee, mm-hmm. those are the country boys that you want to look for. Mm-hmm. Like, this right here is still somewhere
in the city. The South Florida men are city people. They're like New York. You can compare
it's the Alabama, the Tennessee, and stuff like that. The Birmingham people. Those are the country guys that you want. They're like, they don't want to do nothing but fix your car.
Right.
Stuff like that. Love all their women. Stuff
what
like
I
that.
Gathered, what I have gathered is that the South was so full of women who were super submissive that the South is where you're going to find the women who are most rebellious now. That's the problem. I think they were so used to being submissive And we're so used to letting the man take over. So that's why you see a big reverse when you get in this area of men not really doing any of those things. But if you go up north, those women weren't necessarily super submissive ever in their history of
because I know
hundreds of years ago. So
Detroit, most of the women in Detroit, they're not submissive.
Exactly.
I guess that's why they say I.
Like you'll see you'll see more girls back at home fighting dudes than you will see fighting anywhere else.
And I think that's a big difference too. The culture.
And then also that's why I say like your upbringing has a lot to do with how you are as a daughter, how you are in a relationship. Because you have some people that were raised in love and you have people that were raised in life.
I've seen that.
Okay.
We were always raised.
Boys rule, girls rule.
You know what? So like our family, we come from like real big family. And our family like has their roots from. So a lot of them came up here and stuff like that over the years. But being raised off of love and you meet somebody that's raised off of the Bible, it's totally different. It's like you have to teach them everything.
Are you dressed, Ginger?
I go down
there. You really dressed, Ginger, right now. it ain't my fault y'all getting up at 5 in the afternoon.
Ooh, I don't even get up that early.
Because
in between my sleep, I get up to go pick her up and take care of her. So I do, I sleep, break it up, and go back to sleep.
So,
listen. See, I get up, go back to sleep.
Yeah.
I wake up by like 4:50, maybe 5 o'clock, get ready for work,
go
faster. Yeah, I do things. I do my
stuff. So how is it? How can you balance being a mother and also still having a strong, healthy relationship where your daughter? Oh no, no, pause that.
Girls, what's your question?
I have to pause. Okay, so there was a debate at work. We always debate because of me. The conversation came up. Who is the most important person in your family? Is it your child or is it your spouse?
I said
your significant other. My sergeant said your significant other because you can replace your key in 30 minutes. You know what I'm saying? Boom, bam, boom.
Damn right. You can even do it in 5 minutes.
My other co-worker said that his kid. And then in actuality, obviously a parent is always going to say their kid. But now